Hello, citizens of the proud and mighty nation of the Imperium Romaniae! Welcome to the Frontiers, we're playing Crusader Kings 2. We are on a crusade for the Kingdom of Jerusalem, currently being held by... how do you call it? Infidels, yes, that's the word. There's also a host war, apparently. Ali's conquest of Jazeera. Ayyubids are in quite some trouble. The target of our crusade, the Vilaya of Ascalon, has finally fallen to our mighty arms and the wrath of God. Victory is ours. Indeed. Very good. Sure. They are all crusaders, and now they will like me. Both crusader plus 30. My son, the Kinslayer, should also like me more because of this. Yes. Very well. Don't do... You are drawn to a large, cheerful crowd, standing in the front of tall building in Ascalon, which we just took. It seems they have gathered to watch the antics of a man who has climbed onto a building's roof. The despairing man, tired of the hardships of life, is threatening to jump. And several of the onlookers are goading him on. Don't do it! Let's try to talk to the man. I feel like we're not exactly of age to have the strength to grab the man. Nor dexterity. Well, the man jumps. This is a funny one. While keeping a safe distance so as not to alarm him, you lecture him at length about the wonders of life. You follow this with several long-winded anecdotes from your own life, including important moral lessons at the end. The man jumps. At least I have learned what works and what doesn't. Indeed, and we have fulfilled our ambition to improve diplomacy. Delightful, let's improve our martial ability. Should we go to a barber? Actually, I feel like this is a pretty good... very, very fine-looking, wise emperor. 58% on the crusade overall. Very good. We're getting a foothold before pushing forward to the Holy Land. I feel like we could assault. Pretty sure the... Sultan, as they call him, will be busy enough. We have acquired Arsuf and Darum. Hopefully this is not under siege. Doesn't seem to be. We will proceed with the siege of Ascalon with the Mosque of Aghelin, and only then we will push forward to Hebron. But the Holy Land is here. We stand at the front of the gates of Mirabel. I feel like we should switch out ourselves and go to the siege of that thing. Seeing troops in Ascalon. Ah! Apparently you do not have the trait. My son. Maybe he just recently have come of age or something like that. That is a possibility. Now, I wish to command the troops myself. Thank you very much. I will lead the siege of Jerusalem. In fact, we might need to split up our troops some more because supply range is just pathetic in this. Dun-dun-dun. Da, 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 da. 80% on the crusade, which means we will most assuredly be successful at it. Of course, the vassal levies are raised for too long, but that is okay. And I mean, as soon as we're done with the crusade, we might as well go kick her go kick the Doge's ass while we're at it. He has occupied some of the stuff. Or not. Yes, he did occupy some of the stuff, so we might as well take our revenge. The Rumides are attempting to retake the holdings of Kutahya. Hopefully to no avail. We'll find out shortly. How is the culture doing? We did not convert a lot of land, but we did convert some provinces. And Ascalon is now completely controlled by us, which means we can probably push forward to Negev. Acre might also fall. It is rumored that a great warrior from the distant east is currently passing through Jerusalem. He is said to have taken part in 100 battles or more, and his legendary fighting skills are supposedly without peer. Perhaps he could be persuaded to pass on some of his knowledge to you. This man must be found. The news has reached my court that a claimant to my titles, Prince Imre, is hiring man for an attack against me. Imre Arpad, he's got a weak claim on the Imperium Romaniae. By the rights of being my cousin. Where is he? At court in Rostock. Arensberg. Rostock. You are a brother of Tutor Decorda. I expected better from you. What a disappointing bastard. You ungrateful scum. Indeed, success. We have gotten rid of the adventurer. And nobody threatens our titles. Very good. Now I'm pretty sure we might actually be able to just pile on the men on Jerusalem and assault it. But that would cost me many men. But really, does it matter that much? Duke of Adrianopolis, he is my vassal. Excuse me? You must stop this plot immediately. What about you? We shall imprison you and ransom back. I don't care about this guy. You can plot whatever you please, my boy. Might as well get better at it if you're trying some murder. Why is the German Emperor not participating? German Emperor is a very selfish man, I must admit. You bloody scoundrel. He's like, nope, not crusading. Not crusading at all. How dare he? We are the same kin. He is simply misguided. Poor soul. Gain some money for the heathen's daughters, I guess. Mirabelle must fall. Otherwise we might be in for some deep trouble. Pretty sure I had more armies than this. Huh. Maybe I did not. Ah, he didn't gain a point, alas. Ah, and yes, you can go back to you doing your stuff. Your services are no longer necessary. Good. We are about to take Mirabel, which will most likely mean the end of the war here. But my god, do the sieges proceed slowly. The target of our crusade, the Velaya of Mirabel, has finally fallen to our mighty arms in the wrath of God. Victory is ours indeed. This should mean the successful end for the crusade. In just a moment. Beersheb is ours. Farida is complaining. Yes! Deus vult! The third Catholic crusade for Jerusalem has ended, Pope I. The Lord has granted the Emperor Henri II of Imperium Romaniae victory in the crusade for Jerusalem against Sultan Abianus of Ayyubid Sultanate. Pope Sylvester V has called for a month of celebration across the whole Christian world. And it all went to the Countess of Negev, whose husband is the Count of Dorostotum and Nicopolis, Chancellor of Moesia. He is under my command, so technically, all of that stuff might eventually get inherited. Interesting. Would you like to become a vassal of mine? Distant realm, no. Oh well. We'll see what happens after that. Maybe she will usurp a title or two? Well, at least the Holy Land is in the rightful hands, right? At last. Let's go deal with the bees and threats. This is getting quite obnoxious. Nothing passes out of my realm. Only in. There's only one way. In. Of course, the Muslims might call it jihad against it. But they might actually fail. Especially if, it falls to under our fold, and we call for some allies, and we ourselves are not weak. Not weak at all. We'd certainly stand a decent chance. Probably should split them up like so. Besides, the god would never allow for such a thing, Ethinjori. Vassalization doesn't work. We have already established that. It's a distant realm, she says. Distant realm, she said. For that reason, I might need Cyprus very shortly here. Considering that he should be pretty weak right now after this whole crusading thing. Blasphemy is this, Ethinjori? Of course, the god only favors us. You always have. All right. Very well. We could hold the grand tournament. We could try, at least. But I feel it would be much better for us to go ahead for a claim war. There's your claim on Limizol. Of course, I do have some de jure claims. I forgot. Can call in the king and the emperor. Let's give him a little bit of money so he has more incentive. And again, we'll have to go through this very, very much tedious process of gathering armies, but alas. God wills it. We will make, if she thinks that the realm is too distant, then we will make her realm closer. Of course, all of that is an assumption that she won't like create some kingdoms or usurp them. In the meantime, that would be devastatingly bad. Let's go to Abydos. Very well. Go to Aegean Sea. Alright, the King of Norway's in. And the Emperor of German Empire has finally decided to bless me with his presence. At last. Perhaps I should level up something over here. Yes, indeed. I am attacking for snipers, since I have de jure claims on that, rightfully, as the king of Greece. Surely, the so-called sultan will not resist us for long, because his armies are weak and small, and ours is large. We'll just run in there. Oh, very well. We have converted Abydos. We'll just move along the coast like this. Our armies are large, and his armies are small. Might as well declare war on Sultan of Rome. Ah, no. Oh yes, and we also have a truce, okay. I thought we cannot declare war, and it was very sad. Truces are expiring, however. Just a little bit annoying. Oh, come on. Taking so long for like 25 men to arrive in the boats? Well, I mean, sure, I'm waiting for all of you. I love you. I love everyone. Why do we have such a low force limit here? This province has typhoid fever. Oh, yuck. One child lacks a guardian, or Brie van Vlaanderen. Don't necessarily care about him. Wasn't that the guy, the son of the Norwegian prince? Pretty sure he was. Not important. in any case. Your righteous struggle against the heathens has not gone unnoticed. I have dispatched a papal emissary with sufficient funds to assist you, Ave Maria. Thankfully, the Pope is willing to help. Very, very good. Very good. Seems like a German Empire has arrived. In all its glory. Okay, and get onto boats. Sultan Abianos has called Sultan of Rome. So we are going to be fighting Rome after all. That is a little bit unfortunate, but that's okay. We have the might of the German fleets. Sorry, the might of the German armies behind us. We have 40,000 men. Just as well. So I think that's the time we're going to put a cut in between our YouTube episodes. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to comment, rate, and possibly subscribe to my channel for videos like this. If you are watching this on YouTube, you're on a stream, stay frosty. We're going to continue in just a second.